What's up everybody, it's Sean here and I'm back today to give you a review of the size collaboration with New Balance on this 1906R from the Diamond District Pack in the succulent green colorway. First off, I want to give a huge thank you over to Size Canada for sending me over this pair. This is the latest size exclusive colorway of the New Balance 1906R. And they released today, November 2nd, for a price of $210, which is roughly $155 converted. So the official colorway for this shoe is beige, gray, and succulent green. And these released alongside a gray colorway, which were not available in Canada. So I think the gray pair was exclusive to size UK. But regardless, both colorways are part of this Diamond District pack, which is inspired by vintage watch collecting from the pawn shops in New York City's Diamond District. So while this isn't an official tie-in, people are saying that the colorway for this specific shoe is based off of Vacheron Constantin's traditional watch. So I'll add an image of that watch here so you guys can kind of see we have a very similar color scheme of green and gold. And before I forget, the official product code for this shoe is M1906RSG. So jumping right into the details of this shoe, you'll see that the upper of this 1906R, it's been tweaked from a material choice standpoint, giving it more of an elevated and luxurious feel. So on the toe box itself, we have this green colored mesh, and right above this, we have this green cut of suede with the New Balance N logo in gold. Overlaid on both sides of the toe box, we have this asymmetrical overlay of this flatter nubuck, and then next to this, the panels here are covered in this grid-shaped nylon, and then surrounding the front toe cap, we have this hairy or long-haired suede in this faded grayish tone. Moving downwards towards the side of the shoe, so covering a portion of the mid panel, we have this hairy, long-haired green colored suede, and then for the middle two eyelets, these loop through these yellow colored woven straps with this reflective 3M line running down the center. And this is what New Balance calls their end lock technology. So basically when you tie up your laces, the tension from the laces will pull these two straps, which run down the entire body of the shoe, giving you added lockdown and more support. So you can see the New Balance N logo here. This is done in a mix of gray, yellow, and green. And then underneath this, we have more of that grid style nylon, that hairy long-haired suede, along with an overlay of this dark grayish brown colored nubuck. And you can see this nubuck covers the top three eyelets and it wraps around the back of the shoe as well. Pressed onto the lateral side only, we have 1906R branding in yellow. And then surrounding the back of the heel, we have a green colored TPU heel clip, which gives you added structure and support for the back end of the shoe. Right above this, we have this NB branding, and then the top of the heel is covered in that long-haired green suede, and we have a small yellow-colored pull tab, which is something that's not usually found on a 1906R. As far as the laces go, so these only come with one lace option, and they're a flat-style lace done in this pale yellow tone. Underneath this, the tongue is padded, but it's covered in this bold green-colored mesh, and this is more of an open-style mesh. And then running down the tongue of the shoe at the very top, instead of the typical 1906R branding, we have this thin woven strip which gives the shoe more of an elevated and elegant look. So the back of the tongue and the interior liner of the shoe, this is covered in a grayish brown colored lining. And then moving on to the insoles, so these come with a pretty well padded ortholite branded foam insole. So it's lined in this green finish on top, and we have New Balance 1906R branding pressed onto the heel in a mix of green and gold. So the upper of the shoe sits atop this full-length Absorb and Absorb SBS foam midsole. So the midsole for the most part is painted in this grayish-brown tone, but we have more of a tan-colored hit on the lateral forefoot. And in addition to Absorb and Absorb SBS, we also have New Balance's energy technology, which is visible with these gel-like pillars visible on the lateral heel. And this is put in place to help with impact protection and shock absorption. Finally, turning this pair over to the bottom, so the outsole here is your standard 1906R outsole, but in this case, it's crafted out of a mix of black and yellow colored rubber. We have these grooves on the forefoot to give you added flexibility, along with this diamond shaped traction pattern. And underneath the rubber, we have a green colored TPU shank plate, which is what New Balance calls their stability web technology. And this is there to help with torsional rigidity and midfoot support, and to help prevent your foot from twisting when you're walking or running. So that breaks down the look and the construction of this pair. And in terms of sizing, to me these fit like most of my 1906Rs in my collection, so I personally recommend sticking true to size. My foot measures as a true size 10, slightly on the wider side, and I pretty much wear a size 10 across the board in all 1906Rs. So getting these in a size 10, they fit me perfectly, it's not too snug, it's not too loose. There's about a finger's width space between the edge of the shoe and the top of my toe, so I found that it fit me perfectly. but whatever size you normally wear for the 1906R, I know some people with really wide feet, they prefer to go up half a size. I'd stick with that same size that you typically wear for this colorway. And to give you guys a point of comparison, I also usually wear a size 10 in other silhouettes like the 2002R, 860V2, and a lot of the made in UK models like the 991 and the 1500. Whereas I usually go down a half size to a 9.5 in a lot of made in USA pairs like the 992, 993, and most of the 990 series. Moving on to the comfort of this shoe, so these feel like any other 1906R, which is a great thing. In my opinion, this is a very comfortable silhouette, and similar to the praise I gave the 2002R, because it utilizes the exact same tooling, it's gonna feel great underfoot. It's a very well-balanced sneaker. You're gonna feel a decent amount of squishiness and softness underfoot without being overly soft and mushy, so you have the comfort factor, but it still gives you a lot of support as well. So this is a model that I can wear for many hours just standing on my feet. And when people ask me for recommendations for shoes to wear on vacation, for example, I would not hesitate to recommend a 1906R. Last but not least, from a quality and craftsmanship standpoint, so like I mentioned earlier in this review, the materials on the upper definitely feel more upgraded over the typical more performance-oriented look of the 1906R. So because it utilizes a lot of these suedes, the nubucks, you can really feel the difference from a quality standpoint, so I was happy about that. And from a build and craftsmanship standpoint, same thing, there weren't any major issues that I could see. The glue stains were pretty minimal, the stitch job was good, the panels were placed and stitched on consistently. So even though there's no size branding on this shoe, this is a size exclusive color, but it does feel a little bit more special compared to a typical GR. So with all that out of the way now, let's toss these on feet. I'll lace them up and I'll show you guys how these look. I gotta applaud Size and New Balance for taking a pretty big risk with this pack. This is not a safe colorway whatsoever, but it really gives off the vibe of those high-end watches. So is this a shoe that's gonna be that wearable? For me, it definitely is not. I actually find this colorway to be a pretty tough shoe to pull off clothing-wise. So while it's not gonna be my favorite colorway of the 1906R, I like the creativity of the colorway, and I really like the material choices that they use. So let me know in the comment section down below, what do you guys think about this succulent green colorway of the Size and New Balance 1906R? What are your overall thoughts on the execution of the colorway and the pack itself? And for anyone watching, did you pick up a pair of these today when they dropped? Are you waiting for these to potentially go on sale maybe if they sit? Or is it just not your thing, you're not a fan of the colorway, and this was an easy pass? As always, if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. You can follow me on Instagram at esco8, follow my Twitter or X account at sean.go spelt out, and visit my website at seango.ca. So thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review. Another huge shout out goes out to Size Canada for sending this pair over to me, and I'll catch you guys all in my next video.